Today's recipe, the chicken pasties, is a follow-on from the poached chicken we did yesterday. And providing the family didn't strip the carcass, you should have a nice plate of chicken here. Now, it's still moist because of the cooking method that we used. If you'd roasted your chicken, I guarantee it wouldn't be as juicy as this. What you've also got left is the stock. If you remember, we strained the stock that the chicken was cooked in. I've left it in the fridge overnight. And what you can see on top is this rather unpleasant, or whichever way you want to look at it, layer of fat. And using a spoon, I'm just going to scrape it off because we really don't want to eat that fat. Now, we're going to make a sauce. Whereas you might in the past have made a sauce with flour, butter and milk, like if you're making a macaroni cheese or something, the classic white sauce, this the stock here is going to replace the milk. And the fancy name is a velouté, but it's basically going to be the sauce for the pie. We're not using all of this because we're going to use this tomorrow for our risotto. So we're really making this chicken go a long, long way. The other ingredient I've got is ready roll puff pastry. You can buy it in the block where you have to roll it out yourself, but it's ready made, or you can buy a pack like this, which is even ready rolled for you. So I'm not even going to use a rolling pin. And because I just want this to be a quick dinner, and I'm sure the rest of you do, this is going to take seconds. So a little bit of flour on your work surface, because we don't want it to stick. And you can see this is a little bit sticky because I took it out of the fridge. I'm trying to be organized so it wasn't brittle. But I've probably gone a little bit too far. So if you've done the same as me, don't panic. You see, convenience, and I can still muck it up. I haven't mucked it up, but look at me trying to get it off. I think you'll probably do a better job than I will. Okay, easy peasy. That's my pastry. A little bit more flour on top because I don't want it to stick. Right, next thing, the sauce. It's 3 tablespoons of flour, 2 tablespoons of butter. That's already melted, so I'm just going to heat it up a little bit and I'm going to add my 3 tablespoons of flour. Most of my friends who have made this sauce in the past do guess the amounts once you feel comfortable with it, but obviously for the benefit of those of you who aren't so confident, I've got your measurements. It's 1.5 cups of stock that we're going to use. Now, what is 1.5 cups? It's 300 millilitres or it's 1.5 mugs. Now, this stock isn't going to be liquid, it's going to be quite jelly-ish, okay? Be warned. I can see some of you are going to say, I can't cook like this, this is too gross. But it's really good chicken stock. Let's clear a bit up. Now, over here again, I've got my flour and my butter in here. And I have left it, it looks a bit odd, doesn't it? But what it smells like is cooking biscuits. And that's basically because I've cooked the flour out a little bit. So you don't just want to add your butter flour mix, add your stock. Otherwise you're not going to have much taste to it. But by cooking the flour a little bit till it smells all like hot biscuits, you're not going to have a floury, starchy taste to your sauce. Okay, so now I know the quantity I need to add. I'm going to add half of it. Now, I've got a wooden spoon here, but I've also got a whisk. So any of you just panic and think, oh my God, it's gone lumpy. Don't worry, just scrape your spoon and go in there with a whisk. Okay, it's no panic. And then we just keep whisking. Now that jelly-like stock, which as soon as it hit the heat, turned into liquid again. So, you know, please don't be put off by the fact it's not runny and liquidy. All right, you can see it's getting nice and thick. So I'm gonna add the remainder of my stock. So I'm just going to let it boil away. You don't want it to burn. The thing about heat and cooking is if the heat's too high and you're cooking too fast, lower the heat and you can slow down the whole process and do it at your pace. Obviously, I've been doing this a long time and I don't want to be stood here for ages. But you'll know when it stops getting any thicker. Right, that's not going to go any thicker. So I'll turn off the heat and I'm going to let it cool down for a bit. Over here, I've got 2 options for you, okay? If you don't want to be fussed making individual pasties, which I must admit I like because if I don't cook them all, I can stick them in the freezer, and I love having a freezer stocked with food. It makes me feel really great. Just get a pie dish and stick the whole of the chicken and sauce mixture at the bottom and just put this sheet of pastry over the top. You know, it will fit. Even if it doesn't, you can do it in 2 pieces over the top. 2 holes in the middle, stick it in the oven for 30 minutes, 35 minutes until it's nice and golden on about 200 degrees. You've got a family pie for the table. Some of you might prefer that. But I'm going to do chicken pasties because I don't know who's coming and going in my family. And as I say, I might end up sticking a couple in the freezer. So in that case, I'll be able to put them on this tray with a bit of greaseproof paper in the fridge until I'm going to cook them tonight. So I'm getting ahead as always, okay? So while the sauce is cooling down, I reckon here I'm going to make four pasties. So I'm just going to use a knife to cut this into four. Because there's enough filling here for eight pasties, I'm either going to serve it at the table so you can have extra filling on the side, or when it's made into a pie filling, I'll freeze it at that stage. So the sauce, the chicken and the carrots, what's left, I can put in the freezer, and then in a couple of weeks' time when I fancy chicken pies again, all I have to do is buy ready roll puff pastry and I've got the filling already made. Fantastic, so that's another really good idea. My chicken, when I took it off the bone, I did actually at the same time break it into bite-sized pieces because you don't want massive chunks of chicken. So I just loosen it up a little bit. Loads of dark meat, white meat, absolutely delicious, and all those lovely carrots. And enough sauce to bind, okay? Just hold a bit back. Don't feel like you always have to use everything. It's more important that it looks right. Because if it's too saucy, it's all going to fall out the pasties. If it was in the pie dish, it wouldn't matter so much. Okay, so we get one of our squares of puff pastry. Make sure we get a bit of carrot and a bit of chicken, even quantities of each. You don't want to be stingy with the filling, but being over generous means we're going to have pasties that ooze, which is nice too. Right, so I've got enough filling on there, I'm quite happy. Wet your fingers, just water, like this. Now you can be as fancy as you like, you can do Cornish pasties, you can do anything you like. I'm just trying to get these done so I can get on with some other jobs. I'm going to fold it over, like so, gently press, and then seal the edges like this. Now, at this stage, you can do fancy things like crimping the edge, which is literally pushing two fingers into one finger, like so. Stick your fingers in flour if it's a bit sticky. There we go, all the way around. The crimping isn't just to make it look pretty, it actually makes sure that it really is sealed. Then with the tip of a knife, two very small holes, and that's going to let the steam out so your pasties don't explode. This leftover chicken stock is going in the fridge. I'm going to cover it because, God, I wouldn't want to spill it. And this is going to be perfect for tomorrow's risotto. So that's that done. As I anticipated, I mean, I could have bought more ready roll puff pastry, but I reckon this, do you know, this will be really delicious with rice as another meal. So I'm going to stick it in the freezer as is. I don't want to waste this sauce. So I'm going to stick this in as well, and everything's cool. And I don't put anything in the freezer until it's gone cold, because obviously you get a risk of food poisoning and things like that. So quick mix of my leftovers, which is enough for a meal here for an adult and a child, or you can always pad it out with other things. Nice filling for a jacket potato. See, I'm thinking of ideas as I go along. In fact, that'd be delicious in a jacket potato. I don't have any fancy bags. I've just got a normal plastic bag here. And turn it inside out over your hand. And then, see, I've done this before. And that will go in the freezer. The pasties have been in the fridge all day. And I'm so glad I made these earlier, because after a really chaotic day in London, the last thing I wanted to do was make a meal from scratch. So these little pasties are going to go in at 190 degrees for 20 minutes. And while they're cooking, I will be sautéing my new potatoes, and then dinner will be done. The leftover new potatoes, I actually took some of that lovely chicken fat I was telling you about earlier, and I've pan fried them. So if you have a look, they're going to taste completely different than the new potatoes we had yesterday. And just a little sprinkling of this rock salt, or any salt actually, just a little bit to finish them off, will be delicious. The pasties are also done. They've been in 190 degrees for 20 minutes. And as you know, inside you've got the chicken, you've got your carrots in there, so you can have a nice balanced meal with your potato. And that's about it. So I'm just going to place it up and serve it. Fantastic.
Over here, it was boiling.
You need to cut it in half with your knife and fork.